Buenas tardes.
Good afternoon.
Bien, como ha dicho Majid,
as Majid said,
el estudio de las brigadas
internacionales, the study of international brigades belongs to the present. And that's why I would like to start by explaining why I decided to conduct this research. The city I come from, Mataró, includes an hospital from the International Brigade that was created in 1938. So I thought it would be a good idea because I come from this city, so I wanted to study the healthcare system during in the International Brigades. And I'm really interested in the Spanish Civil War. This is why I decided to focus my research on that topic. Can you hear me well now? Because there were some sound problems before. Can you hear me better? Good. My apologies. So,
as I was saying,
there's an international hospital that was created during the Civil War, and I was really interested in this topic. And as I said, my master's end project was focusing on the international brigades at the beginning of April. There was this division between Valencia and Catalonia, and Vicente Rojo decided to transfer the healthcare services to Catalonia. This is why we had all these hospitals established in Catalonia. We have Las Planas, we have Corbera de Ebro, we have Barcelona hospitals, but also the Mataró Hospital, Sagaró Hospital, or the Santa Coloma de Farnés Hospital. I have focused on that study, and as we can see on the map, we have these four types of hospitals, and it was really interesting to see that we had recovery hospitals, rear guard hospitals, evacuation hospitals, and some came from Murcia, Albacete, Denia. These wounded people, injured people, were referred here, but also these hospitals treated people from the Ebro battle. The injured were first sent to the evacuation hospitals, and there they were treated in two different ways depending on the degree or severity of their wounds. They could spend from 5 to 10 hours waiting to be taken to rear guard hospital, which was the second line. These hospitals we can see with an H, rear guard hospitals like the ones in Barcelona, or Mataró, or Vic. Once they had been sent to these rear guard hospitals, they would get the most important cures. They could be operated or treated for their wounds. And once they were treated, they were either referred to the evacuation hospitals, like the one in Sagaró, or else they were sent or referred to the convalescent hospitals. And at that hospitals, what they did was to have them recover, but then to be sent back to the front. This system that seems easy, even a straight line from the south to the north, actually is not like this. But if we look at this scheme, we can see the referral system. The injured could come from the front, from the battlefield, but also from Denia. But why is Hospital San Pau here? This was not a brigadier hospital, but it was a hospital that was already included in the healthcare system of Catalonia. But from this hospital, they were transferred to Mataró. Why? This is where we have to ask ourselves, why a rear guard hospital transfers a patient to the other rear guard hospital? The reason for that is that at the front, maybe they have selected some hospitals specialized in traumatology, for example, or whatever. But in the case of the San Pau Hospital, we can see that they were sent to Mataró because brigaders had to be evacuated. And most of the transfers took place between the 30th of September and the 8th of October, when the Munich conference took place and the decision to withdraw the international brigades from the civil war in Barcelona. So the transfer from one rear guard hospital to another rear guard hospital could be caused by different reasons. Sometimes a brigader could be referred to the Mataró Hospital, but then back to other hospitals like the San Coloma de Farnés Hospital. In this case, that was a recovery hospital, the evacuation hospital of Sagaró, or the Vic Hospital. And again, we come across the same example. Sometimes the patients were sent for evacuation or to send them back to the front. But why to Vic? If a patient was sent from Mataró to Vic, another rear guard hospital, it was due to the fact that at the Mataró hospital they may not have the medical device they needed or a specialized doctor that was necessary for treating that particular wound. Or maybe because of the fact that this patient had been treated but was unable to go to a recovery hospital because he or she needed some other treatment and they needed extra empty beds, and probably they were sending it to the Vic hospital to avoid the bombings on the coast, the constant bombings on the coast. The Santa Coloma de Farnés case has to be highlighted because it is from there that I could take about 217 brigaders coming from Mataró. We can say that treating the sources directly is very important because we can get names, we can get information on brigaders. But in many cases, it is not totally true information, because when a patient was admitted to hospital, sometimes the names were changed. They were not understanding the names properly, or else they would use, for example, a different rank in the army. Some may be admitted as plain soldiers, but then they are referred as a lieutenant or a captain, and we do not know whether he was appointed as such or not. So some mistakes took place at the hospital. Maybe a soldier decided to change the ranks at the army, but what is the reason for that? That we don't know. With my work, I was trying to highlight the fact that healthcare in the international brigades is not a straight line. It's not a circuit that goes from one hospital to the other. But there are some lines that we still don't understand well. We don't understand why patients were referred to other hospitals. And that is a line of research that I consider interesting, and this is what I focus my work on, why they are sending patients to rear guard hospitals instead of sending them to other institutions.
So this would be all, basically.